Hi friends, meet him. This is Rohan. Rohan's father has a shop where he sells utensils. There were various types of utensils in that shop. Copper jar, iron pan, plates made of steel, glass tumblers, and even utensils made of clay. When his father opens the shop in the morning, he cleans all the things and set them up for display. One day, when Rohan's parents came home from work,
"Tomorrow is the festival of Dhanteras. On this festival, many people buy at least one new utensil for their homes."
"Father, can I go to the shop with you tomorrow? I also want to help you."
"Why not? You can come along and help me set up the shop before the customers start coming."
Rohan slept happily. He got up early in the morning and got ready all by himself.
"Papa, I'm all set."
"Oh wow, let's have breakfast and we'll go to the shop."
Rohan was very excited to help his father. But in his mind, many questions kept popping up throughout the way.
Like, how will Papa put so many utensils? How will a customer find one out of so many utensils?
If a lot of customers come, how will he give each customer a vessel of their choice? As soon as Rohan and his father reached the shop, they saw that two monkeys were jumping here and there, and they threw all the articles of the shop here and there. The shop was in a mess. As soon as the monkeys saw Rohan and his father, they jumped from the window and ran away. Rohan's father got upset seeing the mess.
"Oh my God, what has happened? It is time for customers to come. And how will I keep all the utensils properly in such less time?"
Rohan did not like seeing his father upset. He thought and said,
"Father, don't worry at all. I am there. I will help you."
"Thank God, Rohan, you are there to help me. Rohan, if we keep the same utensils in one place, it will be easy to find them."
Rohan and his father started putting together utensils. Rohan slowly put the large size bowls together first and then the smaller ones. While doing this, Rohan noticed that some of the small bowls are shiny. Some of them are brown in color. And some of the bowls are made of glass. He put the same kind of bowls together one by one.
"Dad, why do all these balls look different?"
"Because they are made of different substances. The shiny ones are made of steel. And the ones which are brown in color, they are made of copper. And these are glass balls. We have to be careful, because they can break easily."
Rohan remembered how his parents have taught him to keep his toys at home, and how his mother and father keep the items in the kitchen. Similarly, Rohan saw that all other utensils are also made of different materials.
"Why utensils are made up of different substances?"
"Rohan, because every substance has different qualities. Like, most of the iron and aluminium utensils are used for cooking. Like this iron pan. Because these are stronger than everything else, the food does not burn."
"Got it, Dad."
Dad hugs Rohan and says,
"Thank you, son. You have made my job very easy."
Meanwhile, many customers started coming. While doing this, Rohan observed that the same type of pot is made of different materials, such as a tumbler is also made of glass as well as steel. A pan is also made of iron as well as aluminium and other materials. Rohan found it all very exciting. When he went to the market, he saw that all these substances make many things, like toys are made of clay, plastic, and even from cloth. He also saw that many different things are made from the same substance. When he reached home, he washed his hands and feet and sat with his mother. How was the day today, Rohan?
Ma, I helped Dad and also learned how different things are made of different substances.
Oh, great! Let's do one thing. Why don't we make a list of what you saw today? Rohan's mother wrote various substances in one column of the list, and in the second column, Rohan wrote all the things one by one and made pictures of what he saw in the market. Rohan was very happy that day. He learned about various materials and different things made from them. Rohan also learned to keep those things in a group, which means to categorize things. Rohan thought that now he will make a list of food items, clothes, and reading items at home and categorize them. How many more items can be classified around you? Can you all make such a list from the objects around you? Children, tell me, can I help you with your problem?
Yes, sister.
Then tell me, what comes to your mind by seeing this stone lying on the ground?
It is white in color.
It is very hard and edgy. It can cause injury.
When the rain comes and I throw it in the chilled water, it sinks and sits down.
Now tell me, what is this?
Hey, this is a chalk. And the teacher in the school also uses chalk to write on the board.
So, now tell me, what does it look like?
It's white in color.
It's hard.
And what will happen when we put it into water?
Come on, let's see now.
All keep quiet and start thinking.
Everyone filled water in a transparent box and put the chalk and stone into it.
Can you tell me what would happen to chalk and stone?
Hey, both of these got sunk in the water.
After a while, everyone saw that the chalk started dissolving in water.
Look, Didi, the chalk has started dissolving in water, but the stone did not dissolve.
I think there are some things in chalk and stone that are similar, but there are some things which are not the same.
Rohan, absolutely. Every substance has its own properties, and on the basis of them, we classify or categorize them.
So it is not necessary that every time a substance falls into the same class or a group.
Absolutely right. According to similarities and differences in properties of substances, they can be grouped or classified.
The utensils in my kitchen are grouped on the basis of their utility, unlike Rohan's shop, where they are grouped on the basis of the materials that the utensils are made of.
I want to know more about the properties of substances.
You can surely understand more by observing things around you. Now tell us, what have you learned about the qualities of stone and chalk?
Both stone and chalk are white in color and hard.
Chalk can dissolve in water, but stone cannot dissolve.
Both can be drowned in the water.
So, is there anything that will float in water?
Oh yes, my paper boat.
Hey, wow, Priya, your friends are very smart.
Thank you, Sarita Didi, for letting us know that hardness, solubility, and sinking or floating in water are among the various properties of substances.
Perfectly said, Rohan and Raju. Similarly, substances have many other properties too. We can learn about many things by exploring them.
Why are we now able to see the objects in the room? The reason is that now light reaches us from these objects. Light from the source falls on the objects and travels to our eye. Light helps us see objects. Do you know what the source of light is called? Objects like the sun or the tube light or the torch are called luminous objects. Can we now see the objects outside the window? Nope, we can't. But the question is why? It's easy, because the light from the outside of the window does not reach us. The wooden shutter blocks this incoming light. Such objects are called opaque objects and they are very large in number. Almost everything around us is opaque if you think about it. Wood, metal, sheets, colored plastic and so on. Now let's open the wooden shutters. Can you see something new? Yes, we see the surroundings through the glass. And I'm sure you know why. What has happened now is that we have a clear glass which allows light to pass through it, allowing us to see through it clearly. Such objects are called transparent objects. Earlier, the wooden shutter was opaque and the opaque objects do not allow light to pass through them. Now look at this shelf which has a milky glass. Are we able to see what's inside? Well, we can't see the things clearly, but you do see something, right? You can probably guess that books are kept inside. Yes, milky glass allows light to pass through it, but only partially, and one can see some light coming through it. What is the difference between the two? While the objects like clear glass are called transparent objects, the objects which allow light to pass through it partially are called as translucent. We can easily think of examples of opaque objects. But can you think of other transparent or translucent objects? Yes, clean water, glass, clear plastic bottles and air are all examples of transparent objects. Can you think of examples of translucent objects? Yes, butter, paper, thin sheet of plastic, milky glass are a few examples of translucent objects.